Hello friends, welcome to Dreamweaver Crocheting with Love. In today's tutorial, I am going to teach you how to work this cute mini frock keychains. Now, here I have done two different pattern of frocks, in which this I have done using a cotton yarn and this one is done using a normal woolen yarn. This frock uses basic stitches of crochet like double crochet stitches. And even the skirt part I am using double crochet stitches except for the last row which has been worked using shell stitches. But even shell stitches I am using double crochet stitches only. This is very easy to do even for an absolute beginner. So let's see how this is done. Now in order to do this mini frocks, the materials that I need is a pair of scissors, a 2.5 mm crochet hook, any two colors as per your choice, 4 stitch markers and a key ring so that I can sew my mini frock and make it into a keychain. So let's start. Now for the yoke part, I'm going for a blue colored yarn. For this, I'll make a slip knot and chain 15. Now once I am done with my 15 chains, I need to slip stitch into my first chain to form a ring. Chain 3. So this will make my first double crochet. Now I need to make one more double crochet into the same space. Again into the next chain, I will be working 2 double crochets. So the sequence for this row is working 2 double crochet into each of the chains. Now since I initially done about 15 chains, so by end of the first row I'll be having about 30 double crochets. So you continue the pattern of working 2 double crochets per chain. So here I've nearly come to the end of my first row. I'm left with 1 stitch. Till now I have done about 28 double crochets, so I will work my last 2 double crochets into this stitch and complete my first row with a slip stitch on my third chain. So the first row of the yoke is done. Here you can see the yoke is done using 2 rows, so the next row would be to work 3 chains. This will be my first double crochet. And then again into the next double crochet, I am going to work increase, that is 2 double crochets into the same stitch. So the pattern sequence for the second row is, into one stitch you will be making 1 double crochet followed by 2 double crochet into the next stitch. So in this way you have to continue the sequence of working 1 double crochet followed by 2 double crochet into the next stitch till the end of the row. So by end of the second row, the number of double crochets you will be having is 45. So here I have come to the end of my second row. I have done my 45th double crochet. I need to slip stitch into my third chain. And here the yoke part is done. So I will cut this yarn and join my new yarn. So this will be the top portion of the yoke part of your frock. Now since we are having about 45 double crochets, so the way we divide for the front, back and the sleeves would be, for the front part and the back part, here this will be the back part, so here I'll keep about 12 double crochets, and for the front 13 double crochets, and for the sleeves of the frock we'll have 10 double crochets each. So in total you will be having 45 double crochets. So using a stitch marker, I'll show you how it is done. Now since the third chain was my first double crochet, so I will count this as the first stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So after the 6 stitches are done, I'll put my stitch marker into the 7th stitch. So here it's 6, 1, 2, 3. 3, 4, 5, 6. So for the sleeves, as I said, I'll be keeping 10 double crochets. So counting from this stitch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'll put my stitch marker over here. Again, for the front part, there are 13 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I'll put the stitch marker into the next double crochet. Again for the next sleeve, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So again here I'm left with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in total, the back part will have 6 plus 6, 12. And the front portion are having 13 double crochets. And for the sleeves, they are 10 each. So now I'll be starting with the skirt portion with my new yarn. So I'll join my yarn to the place where the yarn was cut. I'll tie knots between the two yarns so that they don't loosen out. Now as I work my stitches, I will keep these two yarn under the stitches so that they get hidden. So I'll make three chains and this will count as my first double crochet. Now into the next stitch, I'll be working one double crochet. So I'll be working one double crochet into each stitch till I reach the marker. So in total I'll be working 6 double crochets. So here I'm done with my 6 double crochets. Now, you will need to skip the entire portion of the sleeve and start working from this portion. That is from your marked stitch. So you can remove this marker as well and cut this extra portion of yarn. So again, I need to work about 13 double crochets for the front part. So I worked here 13 double crochets for my front part of the frock. Again I will skip the entire sleeves and work a double crochet into this marked place. So I've come to the end of my first row of skirt. Now I need to slip stitch onto the top of third chain. So this finishes the first row of the skirt. Now in order to make the second row, here you can see I have followed a pattern. that is, I've increased. In order to make your skirt more wider, what I've done is I've made one double crochet into the first stitch, followed by two into the second. So if you want the skirt portion to be more wider, you can follow this pattern. Else, if you want it to be more narrower, you can make one double crochet into each stitch for all the rows that follows. But a skirt won't look good if it is quite narrow. So we will widen it out. I need to chain 3. This makes my first double crochet. Now into the second double crochet, I'll be working 2 double crochet. So the pattern sequence for the second row would be working 1 double crochet into the first stitch, followed by 2 double crochet into the next. So you continue with this pattern till end of the row. Here I am done with my second row of the skirt. Now, as I mentioned earlier, since we are alternately provided increases, that is, worked 1 double crochet into first stitch followed by 2 double crochet into next, this skirt part is getting wider. Now, in order to make it more wide, what I'll be doing for the third row is, I need to chain 3, and this makes my first double crochet, followed by 1 more double crochet into next stitch, and an increase, that is, working 2 double crochet into the next stitch. So the pattern sequence for third row would be 1 double crochet into the first, again 1 more into the second, and into the third stitch you'll be working 2 double crochets. So you continue the sequence of working like this for the entire row. Now here I've come to the end of my third row and slip stitch into the third chain. Now for the fourth and the final row, I need to work these shell stitches so as to give a beautiful edging for your frock. So for that I need to chain 1 and work a single crochet into same stitch. Again, I need to skip the next double crochet and work a shell of 4 double crochet into the next stitch. That is, I'll be working 4 double crochets into my next stitch. And fourth. So I've worked all the 4 double crochets into my next stitch, so that it gives the form of a shell. Again, I need to skip the next and work a single crochet into the next stitch. So the pattern sequence for this row would be to work a single crochet, skip the next stitch, and work a 4 double crochet shell into the next. Again, skip and work a single crochet. So you continue the sequence of working this row in this way. So here I am done with my fourth row. I have slip stitch onto the first single crochet. Now I need to cut my yarn. So the frock part is done. Now in order to make it more beautiful, here as you can see, I have put a little bow to this frock, and here I have sewed a few beads to the frock. So it all depends upon your own creativity. You can sew a little heart or a little flower, whatever is your choice to make your frock more cute and lovely. So for this I've already done this mini flower, which I'll be stitching to the yoke part of my frock like this. Since I've left these two yarns, I need not stitch it. I just pull the two yarns from the back part of my yoke and then tie tight knots so that this flower holds firmly to the yoke part. I'll show you how this flower is done. This tutorial I've already taken for simple flower, but there is a slight variation in this. Since this is a mini flower, what I've done is I've done a magic circle, and into that magic circle I've worked the 5 petals of the flower with the stitch sequence chain 1 followed by 1 half double crochet, and again chain 1 and slip stitch into the magic circle. So again you need to work a chain 1 followed by 1 half double crochet and chain 1 slip stitch. So since this is a mini flower, I'm following this pattern sequence for this flower, and the stitches are also very less so that you get a little flower at the end. So you need to do this 3 more times so that you will get a total of 5 petals, and then cut the yarn and pull the tail off magic circle so that you close the center part of the flower, and you can sew a button or a bead into the center to make it more beautiful. So in case if you are still not clear with this, you can refer to the tutorial in which I have taught you how to make a simple flower. This pattern remains the same, only for the variation comes in place of the stitches that you follow for the petals. Otherwise, both the flowers are somewhat similar. Just you need to take care of the stitches that you work for each of the petals. Now pulling these two yarns. This part. To lower a bit. And to see that the flower is properly aligned in the center, and just pull the next tail through this hole. So once your flower is properly aligned, you can tie tight knots on the back part. So in this way, instead of sewing the flower, you can just join the flower. About 2-3 times you can tie knot and cut off the excessive yarn. So my next step would be attaching my mini frock to the key ring, but before doing that, I need to put the loose ends of my yarn inside. So I'll turn my frock inside out. Put this yarn to the inside part and cut the excessive yarn. In this way, you can put all the extra yarn. Cut this excess part. Similar manner. Now instead of, since this is a different color, if I put it inside, it look quite odd from the front part. So I'll just tie about 2-3 knots again and cut the extra yarn. So I won't put it on the back part, just like this. So once this is done, since I'm attaching my keyring to this portion of the frog, what I'll be doing is I need to cut a long piece of yarn like this and then pass it to the last chain of my ring. I'll go to the top part of the yoke and pull the one of the yarn tail through this. Again, here into the next, I'll pull it like this. Now from the inside part, I need to tie tight knots. About 3-4 times. And then just go through 2-3 stitches on the back part like this. Cut the excess, yeah. So as I showed earlier, I have taken all the loose ends of my yarn into the inner part of my frock, and this cute little keychain is
so
done.
Over here,
you can see these three keychains. I have made the three frocks in three different ways. So even you can add up your own innovations and creativity and design the frock as per your choice. So I hope this tutorial was very useful and interesting for you. In case if you have any queries, please let me know through comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.